Hello everybody, my name is Direct Minecraft, and welcome back to a long-awaited video. I have not uploaded in a while, but I've been doing things, but that's not important. What is important is that we get back to reacting to the Bikini Bottom Inquirer, episode 7, and based on its title, F is for fear. F is for fear. That cannot be a good sign. I haven't watched this yet, so this is a pure reaction. All right, let's go ahead and get into it.
Welcome to Bikini Bottom Inquirer. Here's your host, the official voice of Bikini Bottom, Perch Perkins.
Is that Doodlebob?
Hey, get out of my chair. Sorry, that's our new intern.
Doodlebob's an intern?
And here's the real Perch Perkins.
Thanks, announcer guy.
Wait a second. Do you not know my name? Perch, come on, we went to college together.
Yeah, I totally remember you.
No,
you
he doesn't.
Are,
and honestly, I'm going to get to the story,
It's coming to me.
It's too late, Perch.
Tonight's top stories.
Thank you.
Local hero named Honorary Town Rookie of the Day, even though he doesn't deserve it as much as me. Then, the horrifying truth behind jelly beans is finally revealed. And lastly, giant immaterial letters have mysteriously appeared in the midst of jellyfish fields. Find out what archaeologists are saying about this strange phenomenon. But first, network contracts require us to do a Lurkin segment, so let's get this out of the way early with today's weather.
You might want to stay indoors, as we are experiencing a very high chance of weaponized lightning strikes. There are flames coming in from the east and west, and
flames.
A 90% chance of robotic jellyfish.
All knees will bow to Plankton.
Make that 100% chance of robotic jellyfish wreaking destruction on the city. Other than that, it's a beautiful sunny day here. Okay, that's the weather, Perch. Get me out of here. Send help.
Okay, that's weird.
Oh, Lurch. You know I'm busy doing a show. Send the intern. Yeah, sorry. I don't know where he is right now. No, he'll be fine. Just give me that coffee. All right, Lurch. We'll check back later for any updates.
Okay, there is a lot of things wrong. Wasn't Doodlebob beaten already?
Next up, Honorary Rookie of the Day was once again given to someone other than me.
We're gonna make this kid Honorary Town Rookie of the Day.
For he's a jolly good rookie. For he's a jolly good rookie. For he's a jolly good rookie.
Local hero SpongeBob SquarePants shed his disguise as local fry cook SpongeBob SquarePants earlier today and took to the streets to retrieve a stolen
that was just supposed to be for
sandwich
a joke.
Or something. I mean, who cares? Meanwhile,
Crabs cares.
I sit here every day working tirelessly to keep Bikini Bottom informed without so much as a thank you. And I do good deeds too. Roll that tape of me cleaning up that litter. Hey, what's this litter doing here? See? But
it
it's good to
like
know that these types
wallet.
Of awards are going to the real heroes out there for protecting sandwiches. I mean, this guy must be so brave to take on a criminal half the size of his pinky finger.
Yeah,
great
except
job,
that criminal
SpongeBob.
Is
you
one of the most dangerous
this
in
award
on.
Over me. Give me a break. And that brings me to today's community poll. Vote now and I'll read results live later today. Who do you think deserves the title Honorary Rookie of the Day? Me? Or this rectangle?
That
you
rectangle.
Know what? Hey, Doodlebob. Give me that pencil. There. That's more like it. Get it off me! Get it off me! Stop
oh, that is funny.
Cut to Lurch or something.
Lurch.
Help! Somebody, get me out of here!
Anywho.
Our next story, health and safety violations in Bikini Bottom.
What?
I mean, more than usual.
That's not surprising.
It all started when authorities learned that the Krusty Krab was locking its customers in the building using military-grade armored technology. Here's Officer John Slugfish with a report.
The only thing I wonder is how much
money
did Mr.
After an investigation, it appears that the restaurant is locking its customers in the building using military-grade armored technology.
Yeah, I just said that. Shortly after this news broke, another business was caught illegally selling severed human noses. Here's Officer John Slugfish with a report.
After an investigation, it appears the shop has been illegally selling severed human noses.
How can you tell they're human?
Okay, why did
also,
we bring this guy
in? Also, to be fair, not
in?
Many of you guys even have noses.
As if that wasn't enough. The Department of Underwater Health and Safety is now investigating a lawsuit filed against Big Jelly Bean Corp. When one customer noticed something horrifying about his green jelly beans. And we have that customer on the line now for today's...
Perch Phone.
Mr. Bass, can you hear me?
You can call me Bubble.
Okay, I'm not gonna do that. Tell us about your horrifying jelly bean experience.
Yes, well, I was minding my own business, eating a handful of jelly beans, when I noticed that one of the jelly beans had wiggling antennae, tiny legs, and one bulging red eye.
Oh, that sounds absolutely disgusting.
So, I tried to eat it for several minutes, but it kept running away from me.
Wouldn't you think that was strange
already? When I couldn't
already?
Catch it, I decided to sue.
Wait, that's the same tiny guy who stole the Krabby Patty in the last story. I'm surprised they didn't give you Rookie of the Day for that. I mean, apparently they'll give that award to just about anyone, even though I'm the one. Come on, get that thing away from me. Erase it or something.
Never.
Cut alert.
Never
cut
erase that. I don't
we'll
think
be right back after this
there.
Short message.
Bikini Bottom Inquirer, brought to you by Big Jelly Bean Corp, now less likely to contain vermin.
Big Jelly Bean Corp, we're probably vermin-free.
Okay, that is the stupidest
now,
ad ever.
For our top
I've seen
story.
A lot of stupid ads.
Message Mystery.
A mystery. My
in
kind of
jellyfish fields.
Okay. I'm up for a mystery.
Appears overnight. Without warning.
Okay, I'm getting less.
Even top archaeologists are stumped by this message mystery.
Okay, all right, we get it. That's right. Strange, immaterial letters were uncovered all over jellyfish fields this morning, leaving citizens and scientists alike wondering, what does it mean? Is it a message from aliens? Are they ancient glyphs that were somehow unearthed? Are they just giant metaphors symbolizing a closed-minded character learning something through song?
That's probably that
for
one.
Friends who do probably stuff together. One. U is for you and me. Try it!
N is for anywhere and anytime at all.
Down here in the deep blue sea.
Yeah, we get it. While nobody knows the truth, top archaeologists are working tirelessly to decode the message to no avail. When asked how they feel about decoding such a difficult message, they all said, it just isn't fun. Before we sign off,
that's
I'm getting
message.
Word that the results
fun.
Are in.
The
you
rectangle.
Voted Bikini
on,
Bottom,
SpongeBob.
And now it's time for you to decide who really deserves the title of Honorary Rookie of the Day. And the winner is...
It's you, isn't it?
You know what? This was a stupid poll anyway.
Oh, it was SpongeBob
anyway.
Who won.
Who cares what the people vote? Not like it means anything.
Yes, it
I'm
does.
I'm Perch Perkins. Perch! Oh, thank Neptune.
Oh, so
I finally made it out of that terrible
entity.
Storm. Back in the studio, safe and sound. What is that thing? Perch! Get it off me, Perch! And that's all the news that's fit to float.
Also,
good night.
So, that's a thing. I'm just gonna watch this for a few minutes for fun. All right. So, Final thoughts. I am surprised that Perch and Lurch were actually separate beings. And I'm amazed Lurch managed to get out of Plankton's imagination. But, let's see. I'm just checking out a bit of the video. Let's see. What did I... mystery. I'll be honest, this decoded message says fine. And Bubble Bass is too stupid to realize that if something's moving, it's probably not food. So this is so suing is kind of lame. Also, thinking about the noses, fish don't have noses, so they probably have to. And how do you know they're severed? They could be replicated noses, for all you know. And also, the lock. My biggest question about this episode was how much money did Mr. Krabs even spend on a military-grade defense, and yet Plankton managed to get away. Coming from a guy who hates to lose any amount of money, no matter how small, Mr. Krabs definitely has some in reserve to put up something like this. And the fact that, I'm trying to figure out. And I'm also surprised that Doodle Bob is back, considering Doodle Bob was beaten in an episode, literally named Avram. I am just dumbfounded. And also, Perch Perkins and Lurch Lurkins are actually two separate beings the whole time. And I just thought those two were just one and the same, and they just couldn't figure out how to, like, put them in. Like, wow. That actually surprised me. I am not kidding. Anyway, that's all for today. I'll see you guys when the next episode comes out. And, yeah, that's it. So, bye.